cabled broadcast of the Fernie Ghost Riders. Second last home game of the season, tomorrow night, of course, being the last one, both against the Great Falls Americans. Something interesting I picked out right away when I was looking over the stats today. Top team in the league, we're 3-3 against them.
Yeah, and I think we've given Great Falls the biggest headache all year round. And the thing is, if you look at the stat sheet, Great Falls has beaten everybody in their arena except here. That says a lot, it means a lot, especially in playoff times. Some people say, well, the last two games in the regular season don't really mean much. It does. You want to go in on a winning note. You want to show everybody that, hey, you're moving in a forward direction, and everybody has to know the games that Great Falls has been losing, and they've been losing to Minot, Bismarck, Billings, Kimberly, and us all before playoff time. They got to set a standard. They got to come in here and try to steal two games from us.
We're coming off that 3-2 win in Great Falls. Only two teams have beaten Great Falls in regulation in their building this year. We did it once. Kimberly did it once. I think these guys have, you saw what happened the next night in Bozeman. It was a 2-0 loss on our behalf, but I think these guys are revved up to play Great Falls, and I think it's a good situation. You go into the final weekend of the regular season, you want to go in the playoffs on a high, and you've got the best team in the league. That's a pretty good motivator to get you playing at the top of your game going into the playoffs.
Oh, exactly. And the thing is, like, I thought, and I questioned, I asked Todd Jones, would they be playing Dwyer or Kiskis? Because it doesn't really mean something, but it does mean something. They are here, they're on the ice, and they're going to play. How much ice time? We don't know. But Great Falls wants to beat us badly here before playoffs, because if they face us in the playoff rounds, they don't want to have that in the back of their mind saying, oh no, we haven't beaten Fernie in their arena all year. So this is going to be an awesome game. There's going to be a playoff hockey atmosphere on this ice surface, and each team's trying to show and set the standard for when they want to go into the playoffs.
One thing about Great Falls as well, Pat Dwyer's missed 11 games this season.
Yeah.
Most, if not all of those, due to that suspension that he had. The team invoked suspension. So I think Rickard Gronberg, Great Falls head coach, is going to want to get him on the ice, because he looked rusty in Great Falls. That was his first game back when they played us. He was missing the net. He was fanning on slap shots. And this kid's the MVP of the AWHL this year. He's a heck of a hockey player, and he was not himself in that first game. So Ricard's probably going to want him to get a lot of ice time to get him back to form for the playoffs, I would think, anyway.
Definitely. And again, too, everybody has to remember he suffered a concussion, too. And again, having a suspension also covers up injury status to other teams in the league. You don't want anybody gunning up your main gun on your team, because you don't want to lose them in the playoffs. Question is, how serious was Dwyer hurt with that concussion? We don't know. But everybody knows a concussion is a bad problem. You get hit, and sometimes you might not even play for the rest of the season. So I expect a real physical game against Great Falls, and I expect it to be really hard against Kiskis, Dwyer, and Moe. And they hate playing here.
Rick Kiskis has 99 points this season. It'd be nice for the Fernie Ghost Riders to play spoiler and keep him from hitting that 100-point plateau. But more interesting, we talked about the Riders being 3-3 against Great Falls this year.
Yeah.
The leading scorer in the AWHL averages almost a point and a half a game, has one goal and one assist in six games this year against Fernie. We're really doing a good job of shutting Kiskis down. Dwyer, not so much. He's played six games, he has 11 points.
Yeah.
But his line mate, you'd think some of those points would sort of come along with Kiskis, but 2 points all year long, one of them in the last game they played. Up till that point, when he got that goal, he had one assist all year.
Yeah.
So we've been doing a really good job on their big guys, and that's going to have to happen again tonight.
Yeah.
And another thing we've done a very good job on, if you look back, despite the first game of the year where Great Falls was like 6-9 on the power play,
yeah,
or whatever they were, we have held them scoreless on the power play, I think now, in three straight games. Or did they get one in the last one? I don't remember.
No, they didn't.
But we've held them scoreless on the power play for a long time.
Yeah.
They were on an 0-21 streak against us at one point, and these guys click at 25% on the power play.
Yeah, and also you got to remember too, probably the team that improved on their power play the most in the last month and a half has been the Fernie Ghost Riders. Home improvement on our power play jumped up 4%. On the road, it jumped up 2.5%, almost 3%. So you're looking at 5%, almost 6% increase in the last month on the power play. It showed when we played Kimberly, 3 power play goals in Kimberly. It showed here, 2 power play goals against Kimberly. And it showed in Great Falls when Connor Hughes had the hat trick, and it was all 3 power play goals. The thing is now, oppositions are looking at it, and they know now we do not take penalties against Fernie. They're scoring on their power play, and it's a major headache, because now the way the Ghost Riders play, we're not the biggest team in the league, but we're the physical team, and we like showing it on home ice. And the thing is, and I've always said it, the ice is small, the boards are hard, and you get hurt in this barn. And it's going to be a great affair tonight.
I'll finish off with this unless you have any other thoughts. But Jakob Kolma, there was a lot of concern around Fernie that Jakob Kolma was not going to be available for the team in the playoffs. He was held out of the lineup last weekend because of problems with his transfer from his Czech junior team. Since then, it's been straightened out with the Czech Hockey Federation. And Jakob Kolma, our leading scorer, will be back in the lineup tonight. And number one, that's huge because you don't want Jakob missing 2 weeks before he goes in the playoffs. And number two, just getting him back in time for the playoffs is really the big story.
Oh, you said it. And you look at the stats as well. Jakob Kolma is probably the hottest player on the ice for the last four games. In four games, Jakob had 8 goals. I don't know how many assists. I think it was like 6. The kid is amazing. He's really going out there. And you could tell that Todd Jones has basically gave the instruction to Jakob Kolma and Jan Pasea and young Ryan McLeod out there. Do what you have to do to put that puck in the net. When they are creative, they are dangerous. And when they start moving that puck and they got awesome speed, it caused major troubles for defenses, and it's a goalie's nightmare.
One final note as well. If we talk a little bit about Jakob Kolma and him coming back in the lineup, if I asked you who led the Ghost Riders in scoring against Great Falls this year, who would you say, or do you already know maybe?
Connor Hughes.
Jeremy Robinson.
Oh, really?
Jeremy Robinson, and most of those are assists.
Yeah.
So you got to figure that some of those will come on the power play as well. But Connor with his 3 goals, yeah, you thought he might be up there. But Jeremy Robinson, the diminutive one, leads the Ghost Riders in scoring against the Great Falls Americans. So it'll be up to him and Connor tonight. Jakob didn't play in the last game. He didn't get a chance to play in the Great Falls game at the beginning of the year when him and Jan didn't make it across the border. So he's seen limited action against Great Falls. But here's a chance for those guys to shine against the top team in the league. Enough said. They got to go in the playoffs with on a high. And what better than play the top team in the league to get you playing at the top of your game going into the postseason?
Thing is, too, look how many teams are watching this, too. Our first round opponents, the Billings Bulls, they want to see how well we do against these guys in our barn. And Billings knows they have a fight in their hands, and I don't think they really wanted to pick us. But tonight's going to show the league what playoff hockey is all about, and it's also going to show that the Fernie Ghost Riders are a true contender for the Bourne Cup Championship.
Well, we'll leave it at that. We'll be back on a blink on your TV screen here on Kootenai Cable with first period action. Fernie Ghost Riders and Great Falls Americans back after this.
Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to make a special presentation. The Fernie Ghost Riders would like to take a moment for two special presentations to two special players on the Fernie Ghost Riders Hockey Club who are playing their second to last junior A hockey game as they are 20-year-olds at the end of the season. First, this individual has lived in Fernie all his life and played the last 4 seasons as a Ghost Rider and is team captain. I would like to call Martin Palmer to come forward, please. We would like Martin to accept a watch engraved with his name and his number and the Fernie Ghost Riders on the back. The watch is being presented by Mr. Dale Nicholson of Jay's Jewelers and John Miller, president of the Fernie Ghost Riders. Palmer across the ice. At this time, we would like to ask Mark to deliver these flowers on behalf of the Fernie Ghost Riders to his mother to show our appreciation for their support over all these years that Mark has been with the team. Trade from Kimberly. He has played the last 3 seasons as a Ghost Rider and 5 seasons total as a junior A level hockey player. He is known as Murphy's Law. Jimmy, thanks for all the memories. We would also like to acknowledge Jim's parents, John and Diane, from Kimberly, who traveled to Fernie for every game. They're also across the ice. On behalf of the Fernie Ghost Riders, his parents, who have been stable and caring for this hockey club. Thanks, Murphy.
I'm going to throw the microphone to you for a couple of comments.
Okay. Here's the time.
I will. Underway here in the first period, puck sent down the ice by Brent Popovich. Chasing it back in his own zone is Adam Ryan. Ryan plays it around to the far side. Jared Saylor steps in front of that puck. Rick Kiskies pushes his man to the board now. Puck comes back to the far point. Godfrey looked to play it, but it bounced off the glass. Now Rick Kiskies, leading scorer in the AWHL, brings the puck to the Fernie line. Turned over, Brett Downey brings it back the other way. Downey chips the puck in. Setting up behind his own net is David Prince. Gives it away to Jeremy Robinson. Robinson in over the line. Looked like he was going to bump with Dwyer. Puck went free to Prince. Played across ice. Sent back through center to Boddy. Dumped it back into Great Falls territory. Prince, top defenseman in the AWHL this year, takes over in his own zone. Jake Posnikov. Backhand pass into Great Falls territory. Now Prince takes over again. Up to Bobby Robbins. He's got some room around Postikov. A pass in front. Puck was put wide of the net by Josh Bertelson. Riders in their own zone. Jeremy Robinson off the backboard. Sends it up on the left wing. Doesn't get it past the point, though. Americans keep it in. Puck is sent deep by Steve Moe. Connor Hughes has it and just taps out of the zone. Mark Palmer picks it up at center. He's chased down by Zach Hedrick, given a bump. Now the Americans bring the puck back the other way. Robbins in over the blue line, but the pass goes onto the far wing. And now Bobby Robbins takes a dive, and Jim Murphy's going to get called. Murphy back after missing 6 games with that knee injury. Face-off just inside the Riders line. Kiskies wins it back to David Prince. Jakob Kolm out there to kill the penalty. He missed the last 3 games because of his ineligibility issues. David Prince rings the puck around, sent to the far corner. Pat Dwyer, league's MVP behind the net. League's leading scorer and the league's MVP out there in the same line together, so the Ghost Riders have to be wary of this power play, but they have done well this year at stopping the Great Falls Americans on the power play. Now Jakob Kolm takes the puck. Jakob Kolm, the only Fernie Ghost Rider to make the All-Star team this year in the AWHL. Kolm takes the puck behind the net. He's had some rest. Americans bring it back up ice. Sauli Sekula brings the puck to the blue line. Great Falls loses it inside the Fernie zone, and Robbie Godfrey backhands it down the ice. Back slowly into his own zone to pick it up is Sauli Sekula. Sekula takes the puck from behind his own net. Rick Kiskies actually brings the puck in over the blue line, dumps it in the corner. Puck around the far side. Now Sekula from the point, dumps it down low, past Pat Dwyer. Kiskies picks it up, puts it back to the point. Connor Hughes tried to tap it out. Americans looking for some room in front of that net, but they can't get in front of Ali. Now David Prince brings it back, gets it to Dwyer. Dwyer just fires it in. Ali gets crossed up with Alex Stout, and Bobby Robbins takes a swipe at it, but misses. Now the puck is all the way down the ice, in behind Great Falls, in behind Great Falls net. Now Scott Foyt brings the puck up ice. Cross ice pass for Josh Bertelson, too far. They'll call that on a 2-line pass. And the faceoff will be back in Great Falls territory, so the power play is offside. Off just inside the Fernie line. Brett Downey on the draw, drops it back to Adrian Chubotti. Chubotti fades back to his own blue line, now looks up ice and just wrists the puck in deep. Back to pick it up is Scott Foyt. He's pocket picked by Brent Popovich, ex-Great Falls American. Now a giveaway to Downey in the slot area. Shot. The save's made. Brett Downey on the draw. Eric Smith for the Americans. Smith toss out of the faceoff circle. That'll bring Justin Hodge in.
Ethan!
Now Sally Sekula from behind the net. Sekula tried to weave his way out over the blue line. Popovich turned him back. Now Popovich bumps inside the zone with Adam Ryan. Puck gets up out of the zone, though, to Eric Smith. He's in over the line, takes a shot, and Ali will glove that and hang on. Now Ryan McLeod on the faceoff in his own zone. The line of McLeod, Colma, and Pashea back together for this game as Colma enters the lineup again, as we said earlier. Now McLeod turns and fires the puck back into Great Falls territory. John Volpe out of his net. Puck squirted between his legs. Now Colma brings it up the near side boards, dumps it back into the corner for McLeod. Pashea behind the net. Tries to get away from Anderson. Eric Smith, rather. Now Pashea still with the puck. Dipping and diving away from Smith. Pashea tried to get in the center ice area for Colma. He was standing at the top of the faceoff circle, but the puck was deflected. And that's going to be a power play for the Ghost Riders as the Great Falls Americans. Justin Hodge goes to the penalty box. Ghost Riders with the man advantage. Puck in Great Falls territory. Dwyer tips it out over the line. Godfrey picks it up at center ice. Cross ice pass to Stout. Stout drops it down low. Picked up by Zach Hedrick in his own zone. Giving away to Robinson just outside the blue line, but Connor Hughes was offside, so he got back out of the side of the blue line. Now Godfrey trying to cross ice pass that Rick Kiske's knocked down. Now Godfrey intercepted that pass as Kiske was looking for Dwyer. Now Robinson in over the blue line. Robinson will try and set up on that far side boards, as he always does. Now Kiske's chases Robbie Godfrey back in his own zone. Godfrey behind the net just leaves it there. Tried to leave it there, but Kiske's ended up picking it up, and the puck was deflected up over top of the net, nearly out of play. Power play, 5 minutes gone in the first period, still no score. League leading Great Falls Americans and the Fernie Ghost Riders. Ryan McLeod, Jakub Colma, Jan Pashea, Adrian Chubody, and Mark Palmer on the power play. Scott Foyt, Brian Hapka, Josh Bertelson, and Steve Moe out there to kill the penalty. Riders nearly lost the puck off the faceoff, but now Colma picks it up. Colma up over his own line. Now stick handles through center. In over the line, a shot, and he falls and scores! Jakub Colma! A bad goal by John Volpe. He wants that one back, I guarantee you. For Jakub Colma on the year, his 37th goal. The Fernie Ghost Riders' only representative on the AWHL All-Star team this year has the Riders up 1-0 on the power play. Team's back at full strength now after that Great Falls, giving up the power play goal. Ryan McLeod at center, strips his man of the puck. McLeod back the other way, in over the line, goes wide. Puck gets to Pashea. Pashea cross ice looking for Colma, just too far. Now back to the point for Murphy, puts it towards the front of the net. It was deflected. Colma tried to knock it down out of midair. Colma takes a bump along the near side boards. Ryan McLeod picks the puck up, puts a pass through the slot area, but nobody home. Now Pashea takes the puck, comes off the sideboards. Pashea still with it. A shot. Volpe makes a save. Rebound right in front of the net. Knocked down. And the Americans bring it out of their own zone. That's Adam Ahern. He dumps it off to Ty Dinema. Now Pashea gets around the first man. Pashea around David Prince. In over the line. Can't get the puck to settle down for a shot. Americans now have it out of their own zone off a skate. Rob Godfrey chases it back.
First goal scored by number 16, Hector Kova.
And now the Americans dump it in on the offside, and the faceoff will come outside the line. Time of that goal, 5:41. Smith tossed out of the faceoff circle for the second time tonight. And for the second time tonight, Justin Hodge will take the faceoff. Americans control off the draw. Pass through center, picked off by Stout as he's looking for Mike Elm. Now a shot from just inside the line. Ali makes the stop. Cullen clears the front of the net. Gets the puck to the near sideboards. Palmer helps out over the blue line. Now Robinson takes the pass off the sideboards, dumps it down into Great Falls territory. David Prince off the sideboards, off the skate of Alex Stout and back into the zone. Now Prince in his own zone, protected by the fact that it's delayed offside. He didn't have to move out of his own zone right away. Now Mark Palmer back just at his own line, dumped the puck up ice for Robinson. Zach Hedrick out of his own zone, plays up to Mike Elm. Elm stick handles in over the line and just dumps the puck into the corner. Alex Stout back to pick it up, dumps the puck up ice for Robinson. Connor Hughes and Jeremy Robinson bump into each other, but the puck is pushed forward to Mark Palmer. Americans take over in their own zone, though. Scott Foyt up the ice. He's got some speed. Foyt in over the line, tries to get around Ryan Cullen. Nice play by Ryan Cullen just to take the man and forget about the puck. Americans have possession, though. Pat Dwyer dumped it in the corner for Kiskis. Back to Dwyer. A shot high over top of the net. Foyt back to his defensive position. Gets a shot on net, but Hughes blocks that. Now Jared Saylor picks it up. Saylor in over the line. Gets around one man, now has the puck behind the net. Puck's bouncing on him, but now able to control it. Just pushes it into the corner. Brett Downey comes out. Now pass away from Dwyer, but Dwyer nearly picked it up anyway. Popovich stick handles away from trouble at center ice and just can't hang on to the puck, though. Dwyer peels off, looking for the pass. And the puck is in skates along the boards, and that'll bring about a whistle. With 8 minutes gone in the first period, Fernie Ghost Riders up 1-0. Chubotti outside the Great Falls line, tips it in. Brent Popovich takes it down the far side boards. He's in the corner with Sally Sekula. Down to help out is Jared Saylor. Saylor, Downey, and Popovich battle down low. Puck is in skates, and now referee Jay McCauley blows the whistle. 11:13 left in the first period. 1-0, Fernie leads. Falls Americans home and cool as the top team in the league. They will finish first. They'll open up the playoffs against the Butte Irish. Playoff schedule released by the league just recently. By the time you hear this game, a couple of the games will already be over, but Great Falls opens at home against Butte on Wednesday, March 28th. Minot opens at home against Bozeman on Wednesday, March 28th. Fernie Ghost Riders travel to Billings Tuesday and Wednesday, so those two games will already be complete by the time this goes on the air, I believe, or just about complete anyway. And the Bismarck Bobcats are in Kimberley Wednesday night to start their series in Kimberley with the Dynamiters. Back to the action on the ice, though. Jakub Koma takes the puck, moves to the high slot area, stick handles away from his man. Coleman now dumps the puck down low, looking for Pashea. McLeod picks it up, tries to tap it back to Pashea. Puck is swept off the sideboards. Americans pick it up. Out of his own zone is Adam Ahern, but he's stripped of the puck. Now Jan Pashea dumps it off the boards for McLeod. McLeod given a bump by Ty Dienema. Now out of their own zone quickly to Adam Ahern, up the middle, picked up by Matt Bidlin. And the Joey Ali got a piece of that puck as it went wide. Now Ty Dinema pushed into the boards by Ryan McLeod. Pashea can't get the puck out over the point. Now, slot from the high slot. What a stop by Ali. Got his glove on it. And now the Riders just fire it down the ice to relieve the pressure. And Joey Ali continues where he left off in the Bozeman game, doing down the playoff stretch. You want him to go into the playoffs hot. There's nothing better than that. Derek Aquila out on the ice now. Derek Aquila just back in the lineup after missing a number of games. Now Adam Nansen and Chris Kissick out with Aquila. Aquila out testing that ankle injury. I believe the only player scratched for the Ghost Riders tonight that I can see would be Kyle Shane. Now the Americans causing the Ghost Riders some trouble in their own zone. Adam Nansen pulled his man down and got away with one. Now Ryan Cullen taps up the near side boards. Nansen can't get it out. Foyt kept it in, but Kissick will be able to carry it out. Kissick gets the puck up to Aquila. Aquila just flips a high one into the Great Falls zone. Now Kissick gets around his man. Kissick first man to the puck. Connor Hughes now comes in to help out and hammers his man. And now the play is frozen around the near side boards. Jeremy Robinson off the faceoff, gets the puck to Palmer. Palmer back to Postnikov, who dumps it down low and behind the net for Robinson. Comes off the sideboards. Palmer tried to get it out front. Connor Hughes was knocked away from the puck before he can get to it. Now Pat Dwyer through the middle. Postnikov watches him. Dwyer gets around Postnikov and has to go behind the net because Postnikov angled him off enough that he couldn't get a shot. Now Connor Hughes tips the puck out over the line, but the linesman says he kept it in. Must have been very close on that side. Now Brandon Briseno off the near side boards. Brings it back to the point. Try to backhander in, but Chubotti knocked it down with his glove. Now Sauli Sekula battles for it. Jeremy Robinson finally picks it up. Four Ghost Riders start up ice. Robinson in over the line. Drops it for Hughes. A shot. Volpe made the save. Now Palmer tried to put the puck out front. Batted away by John Volpe. Sekula pushes Palmer up against the backboards. And now the puck squirts to John Volpe. And he'll hang on. Face-off in Great Falls territory. Ryan McLeod on the draw, but the Americans control. David Prince sends the puck around the near side boards. Murphy pinched in, but Robbins got it in past him. Now the puck dumped in by Steve Moe. Clearing attempt was fanned on. Now Pashea just bumps his man into the glass. Americans trying to bring it back up the far side boards, but Riders get it out. David Prince. Now Jim. I don't think Jim Murphy needs to prove anything out there. We all know he's a warrior, but might be smarter if Jim stayed out of the fisticuffs. He's got that bad knee right now. Just testing it out tonight, and if he happens to go down awkwardly or something, he could be lost for the beginning of the playoffs. Americans in their own zone. Jan Pashea ties up his man, gets the puck out in the high slot area. McLeod taps it back into the corner, but it's picked up by Steve Moe. Moe brings it up ice. He's got Robbins with him. Just dumps it in over the line. Josh Bertelsen with that line as well, but Robbie Godfrey took the puck. Ryan McLeod had a chance to take it away. Robbins gets in the slot area for Moe. Ali makes a blocker stave. Now McLeod dumps it around the far side boards. Pashea just directs it out over the blue line. Now a giveaway to Jakub Koma. Waits for some reinforcements to catch up. In front of the net. But they score! Does that feel good for Popovich? Unbelievable goal by Brent Popovich. What patience he showed on that goal. And if you're Brent Popovich, an ex-Great Falls American player, that's got to feel good. Not only that, but that was a heck of a goal as Popovich took the puck, squared himself backwards to the goaltender, and flipped a backhander behind John Volpe. For Brent Popovich on the year, his sixth goal. Assist going to Jakub Koma. That goal coming at the 12:50 mark. That gives the Riders a 2-0 lead. Now Jared Saylor against Scott Foyt on the far side boards. Giving away to Brett Downey now. Saylor tried to poke it back into the corner. Riders continue to battle down low.
Scored by number 6, Brett Popovich.
And now the whistle.
Assist by number 16, Jakub Koma.
Will send the Great Falls Americans, Brian Hapke, to the box for elbowing. So now the Americans down 2-0 and find themselves shorthanded. Riders off the draw, Jeremy Robinson plays it back to Rob Godfrey, who dumps it down low into the corner. Jared Saylor. Back into the corner for Connor Hughes. Now back to Robinson. Back to the point to Stout. Off the sideboards for Robinson. A shot. Volpe makes the stop. Saylor, Robinson, and Hughes out on the power play. Great Falls wins the draw. Smacks it around the near side boards. Kept in by Rob Godfrey. Down low for Saylor. He couldn't control the puck. Now the Americans get it out. Pat Dwyer takes it and rips it down the ice. Ali out of his net to stop it. Alex Stout will pick it up there. Dwyer and Kiskey's in on the forecheck, but they both go one way, and Alex Stout comes out the other. Now Jeremy Robinson. Pass back to Alex Stout. Stout, nifty back ass through the middle. Into the corner where Connor Hughes would have been if it wouldn't have been held up outside the blue line. Now Ali plays the puck up to his own line. Robinson plays it to Hughes. Hughes sends the puck to Godfrey, who taps it down low. Hughes into the corner, battles with his man. Nearly knocked Adam Ryan over. Now the puck comes off the glass and all the way down the ice. Ali out of his net to settle it down. 52 seconds left on the power play. Fernie already 1-for-2 on the power, or 1-for-1 on the power play tonight, rather. Godfrey plays the puck up to Koma. Koma can't handle it. Palmer nearly took it the other way. Now the puck sent down the ice by Adam Ryan. And Ali gets his glove down on top of it. He'll hang on, play it to Mark Palmer. Palmer plays it up to Pashaya. Pashaya in over the line. Puts a move on one man in the slot area. Shot goes wide. Pashaya back to the point to Palmer. Palmer cross ice for Chubotti. Back in the middle, a shot fanned on. Rebound was right there. Now it's taken to the far side corner by David Prince with just 10 seconds left on the power play. Now Prince through center. Tries to split the defense. Nice job by the Ghost Riders not to let him do it, though. Now Palmer sends the puck up to Koma. Koma through center. Chased down by Hapke, but he steps in between two men. Gets a shot away, but it hits a skate. Jakub Koma is possessed tonight. And now a two-line pass brings the faceoff back into Great Falls territory. Jakub Koma is playing the best I've seen him play in a long time, and that's saying something, considering he's our leading scorer. Those 3 days off, probably A, did him some good rest-wise, and B, he's probably so happy to be back in the lineup before the playoffs. He's on a high right now. Now the faceoff just inside the Great Falls line. Brett Downey battling with his man to try and get on the forecheck. He was held up a bit, but finally gets down there. Now Jared Saylor battling along the near side boards, and the puck is up and over the glass, not a play. That'll be a faceoff. I believe they're going to say it went off the Ghost Rider, so probably just outside the line. Yeah. off the draw. Puck squirts to the far side boards. Ryan Cullen picks it up there, waits, and now drifts one in deep. Puck comes all the way around behind the net and up the near side boards, but puck will come back outside the line. Off the faceoff, Ryan Cullen plays across ice for Stout, who takes a bump from Robbins. Bit of a late hit by Robbins, but not late enough. Now Robbins circles through center. Puck goes off the face mask of Jeremy Robinson, who backhands it calmly to Alex Stout. Stout just flips one through the middle, picked up there by Brian Hapka, sent into Fernie territory. Riders dump it back down the ice. Now Coma, McLeod, and Pichea come over the boards. Three and a half minutes left in the first period. 2-0, Fernie Ghost Riders lead. Ryan Cullen off the draw, plays it rink wide for Alex Stout in his own zone. Now Coma picks it up, sends it over the blue line looking for McLeod, but it was broken up and sent back into Fernie territory. Now Ali puts a puck out front. This is dangerous, but Ali got back in time to make the play. Now off the faceoff, Jakub Coma tried to stick handle out of the zone. Puck squirted free to Ryan McLeod. He got it down the ice. Now Jan Pichea chases Sekula back. Pichea gets in there in front of the net. McLeod can't handle it. Gets in front of the net again. Puck's bouncing in the crease area. Now Coma pulled down. Puck is sent out of the Great Falls zone. Alex Stout cuts it off before it gets to the Fernie line. That's going to be a penalty as Ryan McLeod was pounded into the boards. And Jakub Coma scores! With that goal, Jakub Coma moves into third spot in the AWHL scoring race. And Jakub Coma, I said it once, I'll say it again, he is possessed tonight. 3 points in the first period for Jakub Coma. That goal coming at the 17-10 mark. Ivan Volpe gives up three goals in the first period. And the American section's awfully quiet. Now Connor Hughes off the faceoff. Dumped it in deep into the far corner. Mark Palmer tries to knock his man over. Now the puck brought up ice by Smith. Smith takes a return pass, puts it through the slot area. Mike Elm couldn't handle it. Now Hughes has it. He takes a bump along the far side boards. Zach Hedrick at his own line, puts a pass through center. Connor Hughes bumps into his man. Tries to put his lid back on as Jeremy Robinson comes into the line of shot. Volt makes the stop. Now Justin Hodge takes a bit of a bump in his own zone. Zach Hedrick nearly gives the puck away. Smith through center, goes wide on Murphy, tries to put a pass through the slot area, but Ali, he's down on that one and just covers it up with 2 minutes left in the first period, and the Ghost Riders holding a 3-0 first period lead over the Great Falls Americans. Now Brett Downey off the faceoff, sends a puck up far side for Popovich. It squirts out over the Riders' blue line. Pat Dwyer has it. Played it up to Kiske, who just deflected it to his man, but now Popovich brings it back the other way, plays it down low to Saylor. Popovich bumps with Scott Foyt. Puck comes free though, far side. Chubotti having trouble keeping it in against Brandon Brasseno. Now Rick Kiske and Pat Dwyer in a 2-on-2. Riders play that well as Dwyer blew a tire and couldn't get the puck. Kiske blew a wheel and couldn't get the puck in. Now Kiske along the blue line. Saylor battling for it there, comes out with it momentarily. Now the puck in some feet in front of the Ghost Riders bench. And the whistle. Jeremy Robinson on the draw against Steve Moe. Adrian Chubotti in his own zone, dumps off the sideboards. Mark Palmer sends a puck down the ice for Robinson. Robinson should get there first. Robinson taken hard into the backboards. He'll get right back up, and now a shot from a bad angle, misses the net. Now Moe chased down by Chubotti. Chubotti bumps Moe into the boards. Can't keep the puck in the... Now Hughes and Palmer bump into each other just outside the line. Riders end up with it. Connor Hughes knocks his man down. Now Chubotti sidesteps a hit from his man. Americans send the puck up ice. Picked up by Moe. He's 2-on-1 with Robbins. Took a shot that was wide of the net. Now Mark Palmer has it. Robbins trying to catch up to him. Palmer just carries it through. Robbins gives him a bit of a slash, but no call. Now Connor Hughes bumps his man as Ryan Cullen chases the puck back into his own zone. Alex Stout takes pucks cross ice. Sekula hit by Connor Hughes. He goes down. Now Ryan McLeod bumps into his man. Riders end up with the puck again. Coleman in over the line on David Prince. Bumps him into the backboards. Riders hitting everything that moves out there. Now Alex Stout carries the puck back to the red line. That'll do it for the first period. A period that the Fernie Ghost Riders won physically and on the scoreboard as they blow 3 goals by John Volpe. And the last couple of minutes of that game was a hitting clinic by the Ghost Riders as they tattooed everything with stars and stripes on it. So that's the end of the first period with the score of the Fernie Ghost Riders 3 and the top team in the league, the Great Falls Americans, no score. Back with more second period in a blink on Kootenay Cable. Hey, Sean, get a shot of Jennifer for a second, my color lady. Second period color coming right up. It's supposed to be, she's been taking notes, so we'll see how it goes. First of all, before we get started here, introduce yourself, and you're fairly new to town. What are you doing here?
I am. My name is Jennifer Nickel, and I'm the manager of the Fernie Tourism Association. I've been in town since December, and I'm thrilled to be here, loving every minute of it.
We're trying to hook you on Ghost Riders games so you can talk it up in the chamber. Brett Downey off the draw. Americans tap the puck back to the Fernie side of the red line, but Downey at center just pushes it in over the Great Falls line. Brent Popovich there, but the Americans start back the other way. Pat Dwyer, long shot in, and Ali makes the stop, and he'll hang on for a faceoff. Well, let's throw you in the fire. Your thoughts on the first period?
Two words, Michael. Jakub Koma. A little bit of a slow start to the game for the Ghost Riders, but Jakub Koma's power play goal early on in the first period seemed to lift the team and really got the Ghost Riders' momentum flowing. He's definitely leading this team. On both goals, he's been patient and in complete control, waiting for just the right moment to strike, and he's been successful on both attempts. The Americans, they just haven't found their legs. They've been sloppy with the puck, turning it over on several occasions, and just aren't playing inspired hockey. Fernie needs to keep up the momentum, keep the Americans reeling, and the game's theirs.
I think you're right so far. Here they come in a 3-on-1, and Brett Downey just tapped it wide. Now Popovich. That was very, very observant, by the way. I'm very impressed with that. Now Saylor off the near side boards. Tries to push the puck in deep. Rick Kiske comes in to help out. Popovich stands back, waits for the puck to score it free, but it comes to Pat Dwyer, who heads the other way. Dwyer tried to slap it in on net, but Alex Stout got his stick in the way of that pass. Now Jared Saylor up to the blue line. Puck was knocked down by Downey. Just pushed out to center. Dwyer controls and neutral ice, sends it back into his own zone for David Prince. Now Prince plays it up for Josh Bertelsen. Bertelsen dumps it in behind the net where Ali stops it. Alex Stout plays it off the near side boards. Up the right wing. Mark Palmer takes a bump from Prince. Now the puck is dumped in and Palmer takes another bump. But Palmer will get right back up. And as Bobby Robbins comes in, Joey Ali will hang on to the puck.
Americans have realized they've got to step up to the play. The Ghost Riders in the first period, they were digging in the corners. They were definitely the more aggressive team. The Americans, I think, just walked away at the end of the first period and realized we've got to do something to get the game back in our end.
Ghost Riders face off in their own zone. Joey Ali to his blocker right. Now Prince a shot from the point. And Ali will hang on to that and not give out a rebound. David Prince, the top defenseman in the AWHL this league, made the AWHL All-Star team as well. Give you a bit of a rundown here on who won the awards. The goaltender of the year, Lane Sedavia of Billings. Defenseman of the year, David Prince, who we're seeing tonight from Great Falls. Rookie of the year also went to Lane Sedavia of Billings. Co-coaches of the year, Chad Johnson of Minot and John LaFontaine of Bozeman. Organization of the year, Minot Muskies. And another guy we're seeing here tonight, the AWHL MVP, Pat Dwyer, number 8 on Great Falls. David Prince, number 4 on Great Falls. So you're watching the top defenseman and the AWHL MVP. Now Jeremy Robinson moves the puck in over Great Falls line. Robinson is shot on net. Went off of Palmer and deflected wide. Now Connor Hughes bumps his man in the corner, Bobby Robbins. Robbins fights back but can't get the puck out over the blue line. And now the puck is up and out of play over top of the glass. We see Jim Murphy back out as he continues to test that injured knee. 18-14 left in the second. Off the faceoff, Jakub Koma spins away from his man, tried to get it back to the point to Godfrey, but it was deflected into the corner. Puck off the sideboards, out to center. Murphy just taps it away from the on-rushing Americans. Jan Pashea picks it up, gets it back to Rob Godfrey. Jakub Koma missed the pass to center, but it went off one of the Americans, I think, and into the zone. Now a penalty coming up. As Ryan McLeod was upended, and he went to the backboards. And now the Americans, for the second time tonight, Brian Hapka goes to the penalty box.
I think so. We've already talked about how aggressive the Americans have come out in this period. I think that we'll see a lot more power, plays for the Ghost Riders if they keep up this aggressive play.
Wow, can you say Leslie Visser? You know your hockey, eh? We'll talk about some of the guys you went to school with, because I find that pretty fascinating, the amount of guys that you went to school with that are now in the NHL. Of course, being from back east, that's where a lot of the players come from, but we'll talk about that in a couple minutes. Riders on the power play for the third time tonight. Eric Smith out of his own zone, all the way down the ice. Mike Elm chases it down. Ali out of his net, plays it up the near side. The far side, rather, for Chubody. Elm rips it around behind the net. Palmer can't knock it down. Now Palmer has it. Now the puck up to McLeod. McLeod in alone, but he had to knock the puck down and went behind the net. Now out front, a shot was blocked and skates. Now Prince just waits and dumps it all the way down the ice. High stick made contact with the puck, but no indication was made. Pat Dwyer nearly took the puck away from Palmer. Now a giveaway to Rick Kiskies, who puts the puck wide. Jan Pashea picks it up as it comes off the backboards. Sends it cross ice for Chubody. Chubody fires it in deep. Puck is in behind the net now, picked up by Zach Hedrick. Hedrick flips it up through the middle of the ice, but it hit one of the rafters and drops down. So the faceoff will come back in Great Falls territory.
Program number 1070.
Faceoff just inside the Great Falls line. Rick Kiskies against Jeremy Robinson. Robinson wins the draw, slaps it in the corner where Connor Hughes goes after it. Hughes dumps it off. Now gets it back. Robinson near sideboards, back to the point to start a shot. And Volt makes the stop and he'll just hang on. If you look at goaltending stats in the league, John Volpe has the best goals against average right now in the league, but this is the second time that we've gotten to Volpe in the first period of a hockey game. Last time he let 3 goals in the first period, we saw Ryan Bancroft finish the rest of the game. That night memorable because it was also Adam Nansen's first goal on the air, so I'm sure he remembers that night as he scored the empty netter to seal the 5-3 win. Now Robinson back to the point to start a shot. Looked more like a pass, actually. And Connor Hughes tries to stuff it in from the side of the net. Robinson will get onto the near side boards to cut off that clearing pass by Volpe. Now Stout tries to get it towards the front of the net. Puck and skates. A couple of riders collapse down low to pick up the rebound. Now Jeremy Robinson off the near side boards. Again, he'll set up on the power play from there. Back to Stout, who shoots. Volpe sees it all the way. Rebounds in the high slot area. He let out a juicy one. Robinson steals it again. Back to Stout. Back down to Robinson. He can't control it. Connor Hughes comes in to take over. Into the slot area. Can't get a shot away. And David Prince goes down as Connor Hughes gives him a bit of a shot in the back of the legs. Puck down the ice. David Prince takes over in his own zone. Prince dumps the puck up to his own line. Chris Kissick chases his man down. The Americans, now Rick Kiskies and Jim Murphy are going to go at it. Kiskis and Murphy. Murphy out of the lineup for the last few games. Murphy gets some shots in. Murphy getting the better of the shots in so far on Kiskis. Kiskis a big man, but Murphy, I think, probably the better fighter of the two. Murphy taking a couple shots, but now raining some rice down on Murph on the back of Kiskis' head. Now Murphy and Kiskis tying each other up on the sideboards. Murphy still getting a couple of late shots in. Murphy now tries to come up from underneath. Kiskis loses his grip on Murphy, and Murphy gives him a couple more shots. Now Murphy continues to go at it with Kiskis. Now the linesmen get in there, and the two are separated. That was a good fight, folks. Robinson off the faceoff. Americans control the draw, dump it into Fernie territory. Ali settles it down. Now Palmer.
Number two, Jim Murphy. 5 minutes each for fight.
Connor Hughes out of his own zone. Robinson brings the puck up the near side boards, knocks it in deep. Foyt and Palmer battle for it behind the net. Foyt kicks it up to his stick. He's got some speed, and he'll use it to get out of his own zone. Now cross ice for Josh Bertelsson. Bertelsson into the zone. Postikov cut that pass off. Now Postikov takes a high hit from Bertelsson. Referee looking right at it, but no call. Now Postikov in the corner. Pushed up to the boards by Scott Foyt. Foyt now has to retreat back to his point position. Gives Palmer a whack in the back of the legs. Now a shot from the point. Bounces off the backboards. Doesn't come out front, though. But Bobby Robbins brings it out front. Now Robinson clears the rebound. Robinson takes a bump from Robbins. Now the puck down the ice as Connor Hughes sent it cross ice for Postnikov as Robinson and Robbins were battling in Fernie territory. Now Nansen cuts off Robbins. Good play there by Nansen as that allowed Alex Stout to play the one-on-one. And now Volt makes a long stop, knocks the puck down with his glove, keeps it in. Aquila try to dump it down low. Puck comes back out, skips over the skate. Ryan Cullen, 14:08 left in the second. 3-0, Fernie Ghost Riders lead. Alex Stout out of his own zone, gets the puck up to Aquila at the point. Some speed, now a two-on-one shaping up. Aquila knocked off the puck. Now Chubotti gives his man a bump. Cullen moves to it off the sideboard, gets a shot. Puck went wide of the net. Now Aquila causes some interference in the Fernie zone. Doesn't allow his man to get back on the forecheck. Now Stout brings the puck out. Now it's a two-on-one shaping up the other way. A three-on-one maybe. Stout pass. A shot in the slot. Off the side of the post or off of Volpe's skate. I'm not sure which one. Now a penalty coming up. It looks like it's going to go against Derek Aquila, I think, for tripping. And Aquila's going to go to the penalty box, but this game has really turned into a back-and-forth affair here in the second period. It's up and down the ice right now.
It certainly has. The game certainly has picked up a new momentum. The Americans seem to have come alive. There's a lot of pressure. It's a very aggressive game still, and it's going to be interesting the rest of the period.
I think it's always a gamble when you're up 3-0. I mean, 3-0 is a pretty decent lead, but it's never safe. But when you're the team that's up and you get into a fight, sometimes it tends to fire the other team up, so you really got to be careful about that. But what Jim Murphy did was smart, because he took the Americans' top scorer off the ice with him. So even if Great Falls gets the momentum, they're missing one of their key offensive weapon.
Absolutely. I've always said there's nothing like a good hockey fight on a Friday night, and that was a great fight for sure.
2 minutes to remain. Time, 6:34.
So the Fernie Ghost Riders, 1-for-2 on the power play. Great Falls Americans, 1-for-3 rather. Great Falls Americans still just 0-for-1. Here comes Dwyer, though. Dwyer gets a puck back to the point. Americans can't get a shot away. Now Connor Hughes, he's got a breakaway or some room, at least a shot, and Volpe came well out to cover the angle. Now Palmer pushes Briseno behind the net, knocks him down. Briseno gets a puck out front. Now Connor Hughes, a shot. The rebound lying loose, and Hughes couldn't get a piece of that. Now the Americans come back the other way. Brandon Briseno, cross-ice pass, couldn't connect with Pat Dwyer. Now from the point, puck bounces back to the blue line, now out. Connor Hughes picks it up and just flips it down the ice.
Move, move, move!
3:03 left on the power play. Now Volpe's going to be charged for icing the puck. They let the Americans play it.
Hey,
Now the Americans back in their own zone, 44 seconds left in the power play. Riders up 3-0, 12:06 left in the second period. Pass out front, chipped away from the front of the net by Chubotti. Now a pass down low from Foyt. Gets back to Moe. Moe dumps it back to the line, but it's out over the blue line as Prince has to retreat to center. Now Prince decides he wants to wheel. Pashea watches him. Pashea nearly knocked the puck off his stick. Now Coma in there on the forecheck. Steve Moe wisely heads the other direction from where Coma is. Now a shot from a bad angle went through the crease area. Now Foyt from the point, and Ali makes the glove save, and he'll hang on. Jake Posnikov and Adrian Chubotti discussing maybe what should have happened on that icing play. I don't know whether that was done on purpose. I can't imagine it was, because they gave up the entire length of the ice. It did kill some time, but that's a heck of a gamble if you're doing that on purpose. Just 6 seconds left on this power play now. 11 and a half minutes left in the second. 3-0 Riders lead. Derek Aquila set to come back on the ice. Now, but Prince gets a shot away, goes off the shin pad of Popovich. Now Popovich backhands it down the ice. Riders are back at full strength. Great Falls now 0 for 2 on the power play. Here they come back in over the line. The Great Falls Americans get to the puck to the net. Now a pass out front. It was in some skates. Ali didn't know it was there. Eric Smith was there in the vicinity. That was dangerous. Now Justin Hodge plays the puck back into the corner. Ripped around the far side by Downey, but kept in by Hedrick. And Hedrick just dumps it up into the rafters, and that'll be a whistle. The Americans have come on, enough said.
They certainly have, but I don't think we've talked enough about Ali. You know, the kid is as cool as a cucumber. He's kept his eye on the puck, and he's made every save look effortless.
He's really been playing well lately. In a game that we lost 2-0 in Bozeman, I gave him the first start of the game, even though we lost it 2-0. The other guy made 19 saves. Joey made 37. He's really been outstanding lately. And I know you haven't seen much of Joey this year, but you can see he's quick. He loses the puck. Sometimes he'll lose the puck when he tries to play it, but he's a very quick goaltender. I don't know if you can notice that right off the bat, but he's fast.
Absolutely. He looks amazing. He's playing very well today, very strong. If it keeps up, I don't want to jinx it, but if it keeps it up, I see
a
shutout. Okay.
Never allowed to say the shutout. Oh, the S word. Now Cullen back to his own line to Coma. Coma now gives the puck away. Shot Ali. Waved at it, but it went wide. Now the puck down low, just squirts wide of the net. Coma can't get it out past Hedrick. Cullen takes Hedrick behind the net. Hedrick falls, no call from the official. Now Stout tries to get it up to the blue line. Pashea sends it out to Coma. Coma puts on the brakes, leaves it there for Pashea. Pashea still with it. Can't get his stick on it, and puck comes back to the Americans. They'll head back out. Now McLeod bothering his man as he comes up ice. Adam Ahern gets in over the line, but Chubotti pushes it, or Godfrey rather, pushes it back the other way. Now Coma up to Pashea. Coma catching up. Pashea in on net. Tries to walk around his man and get a breakaway shot there. It would have been a partial breakaway because his man was behind him.
Spin it around! Spin it around! Go, go, go!
Now Godfrey from behind his own goal line. Plays the puck to Posnikov, who just taps it off the boards. Puck went off the stick of Connor Hughes. The Americans send it back down the ice. Rob Godfrey back to touch it first. Pat Dwyer gives him a bump. Americans able to keep it in. Godfrey battling hard with his man along the far side boards. Now a penalty coming up. Now we're going to see a penalty to Rob Godfrey for holding. So it looks like there's going to be a penalty call to both players. Or no, maybe it's just going to be a hold in the stick to Rob Godfrey. So 9.5 minutes left in the second period. 3-0 Riders lead. Downey, Cullen, Chubotti, and Popovich out there is the beginning of this penalty killing unit. I know Todd Jones wanted to get Connor Hughes and Mark Palmer out there. Popovich has the puck. Backhands it, but can't get it out past the point. Now Prince down low. Puck back to the point. And the Great Falls Americans lose the puck outside the line. And now David Prince is going to get a misconduct. I don't think it's going to be a 2-minute penalty. I think it's going to be a 10-minute misconduct. So the Great Falls Americans will not have their top defenseman for the rest of this second period. And now the Ghost Riders get who they want out there on the penalty kill. Now Chubotti cuts off a clearing or a shooting attempt. Puck comes all the way down the ice. Volpe stops it with his stick. Palmer races in on top. Now Sekula taps it up to Pat Dwyer. Dwyer stripped of the puck by Palmer. Palmer loses his stick as the Riders still on the penalty kill, and now the Americans up ice with speed. It's Pat Dwyer, the league's MVP. Leaves it for Kiske's, a shot. Ali made the stop. Now Scott Foyt carries back to the blue line. Shot through traffic. Kiske swiped at it but couldn't get it. And now Palmer dives and gets the puck down the ice with a minute 11 left in the second period. Americans skated up through center. Dwyer. Back pass, a shot! What a save by Ali. Now back to the point, Foyt plays it down the near side boards. Jim Murphy takes a swipe at somebody, he gets away with it. Josh Bertelsen now puts a shot towards the front of the net, it skipped over the stick of Pat Dwyer. Now Palmer golfs it to the point but can't get it out. Connor Hughes in there to help out. Now walking in from the point is Brissano. Ali down on the ice but makes the save, and now another shot high over the net. 30 seconds left in the power play. Sekula has the puck, far point, gets it to Foyt. Foyt down low. Cullen took the puck away from him momentarily, but in comes Dwyer to help out. Now Dwyer, with 15 seconds left in the power play, sends it down low. Cullen pushes his man up against the boards, allows Murphy to come in. Now Murphy tied up as well. Riders get back in their box, 5 seconds left. Foyt down near side boards. Murphy can't get it out over the line. Now it passes the slot area, it's high and wide. And now the faceoff will be outside the Fernie line. Oh. The power play looked good, but they didn't score. That's maybe going to add to the frustration.
Absolutely. I'm sure we're going to see a lot more penalties coming up. Ali looked sharp. They were peppering at the start of the power play, but Ali stayed strong, kept his eye on the puck, and kept the puck out of the net.
Fernie Ghost Riders a little bit scrambly there, but Great Falls Americans do have the top power play in the AWHL. So it wasn't odd to see them dominate like that, but I think maybe a little bit of luck and some good goaltending and some good defensive plays kept this a 3-0 game.
You betcha. And with the defensemen out for the next rest of the period, should be interesting for the Ghost Riders.
Ryan McLeod dumps it in. John Volpe stops it behind his own net. Jan Pashea chases his man. Now a near giveaway to Jakub Koma. Nice play by Alex Stout as he stepped up and kept the puck in. Adam Ryan now plays it up ice. Mike Elm battles with Murphy. Puck comes free. Now the Americans have a chance at it in the high slot area, but it's dumped back to the blue line. Now McLeod has it. Chips it off of Murphy. Still kept in. Pass down low. Riders running around in their own zone. Pass out front, deflected behind the net. Now the Americans bring it out to the high slot area. Shot goes off the side of the net. Now Murphy. Battling along the near side boards. Americans with the territorial control here again. Now Pashea has it. He'll just tip it up off the glass and down the ice. Now Jakub Koma chases his man down. Americans get it through center, though. It's a 3-on-1 into the Fernie zone. Pass across, they score. And you knew that was coming with the way that the Americans were pressing. Time of that goal, 13:41. Off the draw, two body. Brings it up ice. Riders are going to have to match the intensity that the Great Falls Americans have all of a sudden managed to put together. Now Popovich runs into his man. The collision sends Popovich to the ice. Now Downey off the sideboards. Gets it to Popovich, who comes out. They scores! Brent Popovich answers right back! For Brent Popovich, his second goal of the game. And what a goal again by Popovich as he went shelf. Popovich found himself with all sorts of room. Came out front, Volpe went down, and Popovich absolutely roofed that. Brent Popovich's seventh goal in the season. Now Brent Downey. I didn't even hear who scored the Great Falls goal because the crowd was so loud. Now Popovich chases the puck down again. On the forecheck in Great Falls territory. Now a scrum ensues behind the net, and the faceoff will be inside Great Falls territory. The faceoff. Chibati from the point of shot sends the puck high and wide. Now the Americans down 4-1, looking for some offense here. Brandon Brusino takes the puck down the near side boards. Chibati angles him off. Rick Kiske's out on this line as well. Kiske's, Brusino, and Pat Dwyer. Now Chibati sends a puck up to Popovich, who just taps it back to Chibati. Chibati tries to get around his man, but he's taken out cleanly. Now Popovich moves in, gets around Dwyer. Popovich behind the net, pulled down, no penalty called. Now Brian Hapka sends the puck up ice. That'll be an icing call.
Amazing, really, he's come alive. He's keeping the team alive, he's keeping the momentum up, and I think that's what the Ghost Riders need to get them back, scoring, playing hard, digging in the corners, and just keeping themselves in the game.
The Americans backed off right in front there, and it's tough for a hockey player when he sees that much room. First of all, lots of guys will panic, but he came out front, saw Volpe down, and had the presence of mind and the hands to get that thing. I think it hit the top of the net. Like, he really roofed that thing.
It did. Nothing but mesh.
Now we got something going here between Connor Hughes, and I don't know, is that Bobby Robbins? No, Zach Hedrick and Connor Hughes. Robbins is out there, though. Now Robinson knocks his man down, allows Connor Hughes to come in over the line. Hedrick and Hughes bump. Now Robbins takes a hit from Robinson. Long shot in on Ali. He just pushes that aside. Now Godfrey bumps with his man. Puck comes back to the point. Hedrick knocks it down. And Ali made the stop. And he's going to call it a glove hand pass, is McCauley. Americans don't like that call. That's what it's going to be. Four and a half minutes left in the second. 4-1 Riders lead. Off the faceoff, Mike Elm tried to carry the puck in over the blue line. Jim Murphy has it and banks it off the sideboards. Robinson had the puck poked between his legs, or he could have taken off with it the other way. Now a pass through center. Riders chase back in their own zone. Murphy touches up, and it'll be an icing call. And all of a sudden, the pace to this game has slowed down since when Great Falls got that goal. I started to worry about the momentum, but now the Riders have slowed it down again, and that's to their advantage.
Absolutely, 100%. They seem to be in control. They're keeping control of the puck. They've really shut the door on the Americans.
I think if the Americans would have had anything in the next hit shift at all, like a big hit or a nice save by the goaltender or, you know, heaven forbid, a goal, they really could have taken the momentum over and gone with it, but the Riders have really quieted them down. And now they've, with the whistles, it's starting to slow the game down. That is to the Riders' benefit. Now a faceoff in Great Falls territory to the blocker right of John Volpe. Americans win the draw. Try to bring it up ice, but Murphy cuts his man off. Now Adam Nansen, backhand pass to Kisik. Aquila moved up on the puck. He couldn't dump it in. Now Murphy dumps the puck up through center. Kisik went over top of Zach Hedrick. It looked like he might have hit his head on the ice, but Kisik seems to be okay. Now Aquila sends a puck up through center for Nansen. Nice pass there, but Nansen couldn't go anywhere with it. Now Sekula falls. Kisik pulled down. Derek Aquila just missed his man with a hip check. So the Great Falls Americans have gotten a power play out of this. Looked like it was going to be an even up call. I don't know how Rob Godfrey got the only penalty out of that. That is absolutely ridiculous. So the Great Falls Americans tonight, 0 for 3 on the power play. The Americans out of their own zone. Dwyer in over the blue line. Stick handles. Now drops off for Sauli Sekula. Back to the far point. A shot went high and wide over the net. Now Connor Hughes just sweeps it down the ice. Sekula heads back, as does Brian Hapka. This is where they're going to miss David Prince, our top defenseman, in the penalty box. Now Sekula dumps the puck in and went off of Alex Stout, and Ryan Cullen found the puck on his stick in front of the net, a dangerous play. Now Mark Palmer kicks it forward. Palmer chases down Hapka. Ty Dinema behind the net, stick handles. Looked like he was gonna leave it for Dwyer, but now Dinema will start out the other side. Dinema through center, gets away from Palmer, who is sliding. Puck around the glass, out the other side, back to the point, Sekula. Dumps it down low for Dwyer. Cullen moves to him. Dwyer, near sideboards, back to the point to Sekula. Blocked by Mark Palmer, and the puck trickles out over the line. Now a penalty coming up to the Ghost Riders. As Ali makes the stop, it's going to be a two-man advantage for the Americans. We saw this situation in Great Falls as well. Two men, three forwards out for the Riders on this penalty kill. Jakub Koma, Jan Pashea, and Mark Palmer. Now Scott Foyt. Stick handles along the blue line. 29 seconds left.
2 minutes from roughing.
Puck gets back to the point. Foyt winds up. A shot. Ali makes the stop. Rebound comes out. 21 seconds left. Josh Bertelsen. Back to the point. Foyt sends it the other way. And now the puck comes all the way out over the blue line and down the ice with 9 seconds left. 7 seconds left. Americans will have a chance for one more rush up ice as Foyt brought the puck up ice. Now Riders down one man, one power play over. Now Foyt loses the puck off of a skate up to Koma. Koma one-on-one with Scott Foyt. Koma gets a shot on net and Volt made the stop, but Foyt gave Koma a couple of hacks on the wrist. No call from the official. Great Falls now 0 for 4 on the power play, just 57 seconds left in the other power play. Josh Bertelsen plays the puck off. Adam Ryan. Now Connor Hughes watches his man as the Americans get in over the blue line. Pass through the middle looking for Dwyer, but they couldn't connect. Now Ryan takes the puck. He's got Hapka at the point, but decides to go down low to Dwyer. Kiske's missed the pass, and it comes out over the line. Hapka chases it back. He's at his own blue line. Connor Hughes watches the Great Falls power play try and set up. Now Kiske's has it and just risks a dump in. Ali up the far side boards. Dinema battling there with Murphy. Now Posnikov should be able to get this out if he can get to it. And now we're going to see a penalty coming up Macaulay's going to have to start evening these up right now. Great Falls set to go 0 for 5 here if they don't get a shot away in the next 2 seconds. Now one penalty over. Alex Stout will get back out. Foyt from the point. Sends it down low for Kiskies. Tried to get a shot on net, but it hit a skate. Now the Riders down to just one man short again. Americans 0 for 5, and now they score on the power play. Third goal. At the 19:55 mark. The Ghost Riders lead down to 2 goals again as it's now a 4-2 hockey game. So after 2 periods of play, the Fernie Ghost Riders lead the Great Falls Americans by a score of 4-2, and there better be some even up action in the second period, or third period rather, as Jay McCauley gives the Great Falls Americans two-man advantages. Rick Kiske's 100th point on the season. So that's the score after 2 periods of play. The Great Falls Americans trail the Fernie Ghost Riders 4-2. Mark Palmer over to ask what Jay McCauley was thinking in that period. There better be some even up in the third period. As I said, right now the power play is 6-3 in favor of the Great Falls Americans. We'll be back in a blink on Kootenai Cable with third period action. We'll enter the third period on a score of 4-2. Welcome back for the start of the third period. The Fernie Ghost Riders 14-1-2 on the year after leading after 2 periods on home ice. And the Great Falls Americans, when trailing after 2 periods, on the road are 0-7. So the Americans have never won trailing on the road after 2 periods. And the Ghost Riders, all season long, have lost one game.
To announce that one more time, the Fernie Girls Leg Riders have just won the British Columbia Championships. Woo-hoo! One nothing over Grandma, they will be going to the Western Shield.
Right off the snuff, an icing call on the Americans. 4-2, the Ghost Riders lead starting this third period. And if Jay McCauley knows what's good for him, he'll do some even up calls here. He might get chased out of this building tonight. Riders from the point, a shot deflected, doesn't make it through to the net. Now the Americans out of their own zone. Brett Downey knocked it down, but now Brandon Briseno and Pat Dwyer heading over the line. Dwyer with a shot, Ali makes the stop, and he'll hang on with 19 and a half minutes left in the third period. Of events in the second period, but the Ghost Riders still come out of that second with a 2-goal lead. What are your thoughts on the second?
I think that they were pretty frustrated coming at the end of the second period, and rightfully so. There were quite a few questionable calls. There are questionable penalties. They need to forget about what happened at the end of the second, keep the momentum up there, and seal the win.
Now Connor Hughes, as he gets in over the blue line, just shoots it into the corner, and the puck bounces all the way to John Volpe, who hangs on. You don't often see two-man advantages right in a row given to one team, but the Fernie Ghost Riders can only hold off a two-man advantage for so long. But I think that the worst part about it is whenever you give up a goal in the last minute of a period, it is a bit demoralizing, and it's going to be the first minute of this period, maybe the first 2 minutes, that's going to decide how the Ghost Riders are going to show up in the third period.
That's right. Like I said, I think they need to forget about what happened, get their focus back on track, keeping the game strong.
Now the Riders in Great Falls territory. Mark Palmer throws a hit. Americans dump it in deep into Fernie territory. Chibati, first man there, just smacks it off the sideboards. Now stick handles past one man and gets a pass to Connor Hughes through center to Palmer. Palmer gets the puck to Robinson. Now Robinson to Palmer. Pasek up in front of the net, knocked it down with a high stick. And the faceoff's going to come outside the line.
Number 10, 6-6. The Purdy Shirt Company also has a gift certificate for you. Thank you.
Face off in Fernie territory. Robinson on the draw. Wins it against Steve Moe. Now Posnikov sends a puck up. Far side boards. Hughes can't get it out. Puck is sent towards the net, and Ali makes the stop, and he'll hang on. Off the faceoff. Puck squirts over the Fernie line. Palmer and Prince bump. Now Robinson behind the net. Hauled down, no call. Robinson taps the puck to Palmer. Palmer pushed out of the way. Now the Americans bring it up ice. Connor Hughes catches up, so it won't be a 3-on-2. Now Hughes ties up his man as the puck comes toward the front of the net. Now a penalty coming up again to the Ghost Riders. Now that's got to be an even call. That's got to be an even up call. So Bobby Robbins in the penalty box. The Riders start this power play. Jeremy Robinson brought the puck up ice. Americans turn him back. Now Jan Pashea chased back into his own zone by Dwyer.
Penalty. Number 19, Bobby Robbins, checking from behind. 2 minutes.
Now Robinson brings the puck into the line, but they're offside. The Great Falls Americans did have some momentum until they took a pair of penalties here. And I think if the Ghost Riders score here, they're going to set themselves up well. But they need to capitalize on this two-man advantage.
Absolutely. We need strong guys like Jakub Koma to really take charge, show their leadership, get out there and score some more goals.
Lots of offense out there. Jan Pashea. Right now, actually, there's five forwards on the power play right now with a 5-on-3 situation. So we'll see if that pans out. Pashea gets a puck to Connor Hughes at the line, but Riders can't get in. Now a minute 25 left. Pass through center. Palmer gets a puck to the blue line, but Palmer falls. And now Kiske smacks it back down the ice. Riders so far unable to get anything going on this power play. Jakub Koma. Pass to Jeremy Robinson. Robinson in over the line. Takes the puck to the sideboards. Now Connor Hughes chases Pat Dwyer behind the net. They'll ring it around the boards and get it all the way down the ice. It's just 57 seconds left in the power play. Now Robinson skates onto the pass from Ali. Pashea brings the puck out of his own zone. Back pass for Palmer. Palmer bumped off the puck. Now an opportunity here for the Great Falls Americans as they're two men short as Koma plays the puck back to Palmer. Palmer gets a puck to Koma now. Just 30 seconds left in this two-man advantage. Now Robinson in over the line. Pass the slot here for Koma. He scores! Jakub Koma! It's the hat trick for Jakub Koma. So Jakub Koma gets his 39th goal of the year.
Right.
Riders bring the puck in over the line. Robinson. Off the sideboards, power play, 2 seconds left. Stout shoots, Volt makes the stop. Now Connor Hughes out from behind the net.
Inbound!
Americans back at full strength. Now the Riders 2-for-5 on the power play. Puck was lying loose in the slot area. 16:04 left, now a 5-2 lead for the Riders. 16 minutes flat. Ferdy tried to get the puck out of their own zone, but can't. Godfrey takes it behind his own net. Tries to get away from Eric Smith. Puck comes up through center to Sekula. Sekula, cross-ice pass for Foyt. Just dumps it in on Ali. Makes the stop, and he'll hang on.
Said that the Ghost Riders needed. Coma needed to step up to the plate, and he did. Palmer was out there fumbling around like he hadn't played hockey in 3 years. I was quite concerned, but it was glad to see that Coma stepped in, reestablished the 3-goal lead, and they're going strong.
That's very unlike Mark Palmer, who's very good defensively. That's why he's out there on the blue line. And Palmer had some trouble getting around his man at the blue line, but the Riders looked like they weren't going to get anything done on the power play. Jakub Koma takes it from end to end and gets a nice goal to put the Riders back up by 3 goals. Now Koma in on John Volpe as Volpe decided to play the puck as Koma looked like he might get there first. Now McLeod keeps it in, but it bounces out over McLeod's stick on second effort. Now the Americans break in. A shot that trickles towards the net that went off Postnikov, and Ali covers that up. Now the faceoff in Fernie territory. Ty Dynema in the faceoff circle against Ryan McLeod. Shot from the point by Sekula. Ali just hangs on to that. And another whistle, and this bodes well for the Ghost Riders as the whistles slow the game down. Great Falls fans very upset at the fact that Ghost Rider fans were screaming at their players in the penalty box. Well, I don't feel sorry for them. Security listening, and maybe they'll go over there and do something about it, but like I said, I don't feel sorry for them. I don't feel sorry for them either. Now Ryan McLeod tries to get the puck out of the zone. Americans try to stick handle down low. Puck's in front of the net. Postnikov takes his man down. No call from the official. Now Jakub Koma, rubbed out of the play by Ty Dynema. The puck back to Postnikov. Cross ice for Pashaya. Pashaya takes a hit. Now McLeod and Koma forecheck. They nearly take the puck away in Great Falls territory. Now a pass up over the line. Chipped in by Matt Bidlon. Koma plays it out over the line, but Pashaya couldn't catch up to it. Now Prince takes it the other way. Steps around one man. Tried to get a pass into the front of the net. But the Riders do a good job of collapsing back to the front of the net there and helping out their goaltender. Now Nansen chases his man down behind the net. That's Zach Hedrick, who barely gets away from him. Now Aquila looked to line him up, but Hedrick got away from that as well. Dwyer couldn't take the pass. Puck comes back to Hedrick. To Dwyer, who rips one high and wide. Puck gets back nearly to the point. Now it gets out because Derek Aquila was standing there. Now John Volpe looks to play the puck away from Nansen, but plays it right to him. Nansen puts the pass out front, and Kisik was tied up. That was a bad move by John Volpe. Now Nansen with a wrist shot, just put that wide. Aquila moves to the rebound. Aquila bounces off Dwyer. Now Kiske's in his own zone. 13:30 left in this third period. Riders up 5-2. Now Ali makes a stop and a long shot in. Team whenever you can. Now Brandon Brasino will head to the penalty box. So the Fernie Ghost Riders go to the power play for the sixth time tonight. Already 2-for-5. Godfrey plays a pass cross ice for Stout. Back to Godfrey, back to Stout. Stout just rips a high one in. Volpe stops it and fires it down the ice all the way. There's no power play time up on the clock. I guess they're going to time it.
Penalty to number 17, Brandon Rossino, serving the penalty 2 minutes. 2 minutes.
Now Jared Sailor brings the puck in over the line. Josh Bertelsen and Sailor headed for a collision in the corner, but puck was lying loose, so they just played the puck instead. Now Sailor down low. Hughes plays it to Robinson. Back to the point for Stout. Stout gets a shot. Volpe makes the save. Rebounds in the crease, the slot area rather. Sailor couldn't get a shot away. And now the puck is ripped down the ice. Ali stops it. 12 and a half minutes left. No idea how much power play time's left as they no time on the clock, but they're probably timing it from the stopwatch.
Go hard, go hard!
Now Hughes tries to get the puck in over the line. Dumps it up for Sailor. And Sailor puts the puck into the crowd and out of play.
This great game has been a real adrenaline rush. It's been up, it's been down. The momentum has shifted from one team to the next, back and forth, and it's definitely in the Ghost Riders' court right now.
5-2 they lead, 53 seconds left on the power play, which has now gone up on the clock. 12-14 left in the third period. Ryan McLeod off the faceoff, taps it back to the point to Chubotti. Chubotti down low for Pashea. Back down to the corner for McLeod. McLeod can't catch up to it, so he skates it behind the net. Now taps it back to the point for Palmer. Fake the shot, now puts it down low. Coma back to McLeod. Try to get a shot away, and he fanned on it twice. Now Jan Pashea, 33 seconds left on the power play, off that sideboards. Now the puck came dangerously close to the front of the net, and it's ripped up and out of play again by Sally Sekula. McLeod on the faceoff with 22 seconds left in the power play. Jan Pashea dumps it down low for McLeod. McLeod back up the sideboards for Pashea. Puck squirts to the point for Chubotti. Chubotti cross-ice pass for Palmer. Palmer gets a shot, or more like a pass through the slot area. He's looking for Coma, I think. Chubotti cuts off that clearing attempt by Dwyer. Now Pashea, 3 seconds left. Pashea down low. McLeod stick handles, gets it to Coma. A shot from a bad angle. Puck's on the side of the net. Fans thought it went in. And now Pashea gets a shot, and Volpe makes the stop. Brett Downey. He'll back out of the faceoff circle as he's tossed out. Jared Sailor and Brent Popovich now switch sides, and Popovich will take the draw. 2 goals on the night. Jakub Kolma and Brent Popovich have done all the scoring tonight for Fernie. Jakub Kolma with a hat trick. Popovich with 2 goals. Now Kiskis goes after Popovich and pulls him down. No call. Now Hedrick goes into the corner. Maybe there will be a call on that. Kiskis is going to get an interference call, and he will go for hauling Popovich down. That's another one of those brain cramps we just talked about, an interference penalty. Brent Popovich, an ex-Great Falls American player, him and Rick Kiskis are going out in the corner, and Kiskis just pulled him down. You can't do that. Your team has to have a chance to get back into the game.
Absolutely, and good choice of words. I like that brain cramp, but this will keep the momentum going for the Ghost Riders. Like we've talked about it all game, momentum, 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 and Americans have to take a look at what they're doing and really think about what they're doing before they do it, because it's just going to hurt them in the end.
And here we go here as Ryan McLeod puts one off the side of the net, and it's on the mesh, but it's on the side of the net, and there'll be a face-off. I'm not sure I've ever seen somebody roof it off the outside crossbar, and maybe, I don't know if that's why the face-off's outside the line or whether there was a Ghost Rider in the crease, I'm not too sure, but for whatever reason, the face-off is now outside the line. Riders control. Jan Pashea gets it to Mark Palmer. Nice play by Pashea as he ripped a cross-ice pass. Now Palmer puts it off the sideboards. Chubotti keeps it in as Steve Moe tried to get it out. Now down low for McLeod. McLeod to Pashea. Pashea back to the point for Palmer. Palmer looks to wind up and shoot, but goes back to Chubotti. Down low for Pashea. Shot on net from a bad angle. Volpe kicked that out. Now Palmer. Cross-ice pass for Chubotti. He winds up. Goes for the pass instead and puts it right into Steve Moe. Now Palmer behind his own net. Watched there by Josh Bertelsen. Palmer Palmer can't get the puck up through the middle as it was cut off by Mo. Now Chibati stick handling, chased back by Bertelsen. 50 seconds left in the power play. Connor Hughes now takes the pass through center, gets it to Robinson. He'll set up on those sideboards. You know he does every time. Now Connor Hughes back to Robinson. Back to the point to Stout. He's the trigger man on the power play. That's who they want to get the puck to, is Alex Stout. Now Robinson decides he wants to shoot and puts it high over top of the net. Godfrey plays it to Stout. Stout's got some room to shoot it and does just put it high and wide over the net. Godfrey chased back into his own zone. Still 15 seconds left on this power play for Fernie. Now Alex Stout taps it off the sideboards for Hughes. Hughes took a bit of a slash, but no call. Now Hughes has it just outside the line and just decides to wrist one in. Foyt went up after it, but Robinson gets in there first. Robinson's hauled down. Foyt maybe got away with a bit of one there. Now Foyt with speed, up ice, just dumps it into Fernie territory. Puck comes all the way through the crease area off the sideboards. Now Godfrey has it. He'll send it back to the point, but not out. Now Hughes has it. Kicks it up to his skate. It's a two-on-one here, Hughes and Saylor. Saylor cuts it on net, gets it to Robinson. Oh, what a stop by Volpe. Now the puck down low for Saylor. Saylor squares his body and has Brian Hapka bounce off of him. Nice move by Jeremy Robinson, but couldn't quite put the puck between John Volpe's legs. As an assist on Jakub Koma's third goal of the night tonight. There's only been one assist given on every single goal tonight except for Ty Dinema's goal from Pat Dwyer and Rick Kiskey's. Everything else has been a one-assist effort. 8:23 left. Ryan McLeod in the faceoff circle. Faceoff in Great Falls territory. Jan Pashea, Jakub Koma, Ryan McLeod, Ryan Cullen, and Jim Murphy. The puck gets back to Cullen at the point, but it squirts out past him. Americans heavy on the forecheck right now. Very fast to get on the forecheck. Now McLeod and Sekula battle. McLeod goes down, but causes Sekula to head back into his own zone. And they're going to call Sekula on the interference call. They get their seventh opportunity of the night. It's pretty hard to score if you're shorthanded. We talked about that before, and the Great Falls Americans keep doing it to themselves. 8:13 left, a three-goal lead. Now 2 minutes of that or less is going to tick off in power play time. The Ghost Riders are starting to look good here. Now Ryan McLeod faces Rick Kiskey's in the face-off circle. Koma taps it back to Palmer.
Number seven, Sale Sikala.
Pashea taps it free to McLeod. McLeod tried to stick handle up the boards, but he was taken out. That leaves the puck free for Pashea. Puts it out front. Well, Colma tried the one-timer, but it went through his skates. Now Chibati. Chibati behind the net, stick handling, waiting for something to develop. Now plays the puck up to Pashea. Pashea side steps check from Dwyer. Jakub Koma tried to get around Scott Foyt now. Koma has the puck in the corner. Two men come in to help out on Koma. Now McLeod taps it back to Koma, back to the point to Palmer. Palmer with a shot, more like a pass again, I think. Now Rick Kiskey's brings it up through the middle, try to get it to Dwyer. Palmer will get back to the puck and try and cut him off. Now Palmer out of the corner with it, tries to get it past Dwyer, but went back to Chibati instead. Now Chibati battling two Americans behind the net. Now Chibati sheds the stick of Rick Kiskis and gets up to Jeremy Robinson. Robinson chips it into the far corner. McLeod goes after it. David Prince is there. Robinson with the puck behind the net as McLeod got it to him there. Now back to the point to Stout. He'll play it to Godfrey. Godfrey with a shot that goes wide of the net. Stout races to keep it in. Barely does. Just taps it down low for Robinson, but it goes past him. And now Prince has it. Puts it off Robinson, though. Can't get it out over the blue line. Now McLeod back to Robinson. Robinson off those sideboards, 30 seconds left. Back to the point to Stout. Back down to Robinson. Back to Stout with some room, so he'll shoot a shot. Volpe made the first stop, the rebound made the second stop. Now the Americans. Rick Kiskey's Nearly got away on the breakaway there. Nice job by Joey Ali to get out and disrupt that, though. Now Alex Stout with 6 seconds left. Taps the puck up to Jared Saylor. Saylor in over the line, tried to get around his man. Hughes following up behind the net. Now the team's even strength, 6:09 left. Saylor dumps the puck behind the net looking for Robinson. Robinson tried to skate away from his man. Now Hughes comes in to help out. Puck is in skates. Josh Bertelsen tries to freeze it. Now Robinson, who's been out there for a lengthy shift, will follow the play up ice. Now Bertelsen with a shot. Ali with a glove save. .44 left in the third period. 5-2 Ghost Riders lead. 2-body behind the net. Plays it off to Posnikov. Now 2-body rips it around past the point. Icing waved off as Aquila got in the way of Hapka and didn't let him play the puck. Now Nansen puts a pass through the middle. Missed everybody though. Kisik was in the area, but he was skating towards the sideboards and the Americans just decided to bring it out. Now 2-body into the corner with Eric Smith. 2-body ties up Smith. Now Mike Elm behind the net. Elm tried the wraparound, tried to stuff it in the short side. Now comes out the other side of the net, but loses the puck. Elm turns and fires it towards the front. Went right through Smith. Now the Americans behind the net looking to set something up here to get it in front of the net, but they can't as the puck's down the ice. Now Aquila chasing the puck down, so Volpe comes out to play it. Now Downey brings off the sideboards, just rips it into Great Falls territory. Volpe out of his own net to play it. 4:53 left. 5-2 Riders lead. Jared Saylor bumps into his man, battles for the puck in the corner. Saylor, big physical forward, ties the puck up along the near sideboards in the corner. Now Downey taking a bit of a working over. He stays with the play. Puck is still tied up there. 4:25 left now in the third period. Riders doing a good job of taking some time off the clock here. Stays, that's key.
Absolutely. I think for the next game and getting into the playoffs that the Ghost Riders need to take a look at the power play. You know, we have managed to capitalize on a couple of instances this game, but there were also a couple of opportunities for the Americans to score shorthanded. So I think they really need to clean up the power play and stay aggressive.
Yeah, the Americans have the talent to score shorthanded, that's for sure. 4:09 left in the game. 5-2. Fernie leads. Alex Stout back for the puck. Now Sauli Sekula behind the Great Falls blue line, plays it up the middle. Picked up there by Ty Dinema. The shot on Ali and he'll hang on. Now Robinson on the faceoff, 3:51 left. Palmer off the draw, gets the puck out over the line, pass through the middle for Connor Hughes, but it went scooting by him. Now Ryan Cullen falls as he tries to play the puck just outside the line. Mark Palmer back to cover his position, though. Nice play by Mark Palmer to recognize the situation and get back and play that puck. Now Alex Stout. Puck comes to his side, but it's kept in by the Americans. Connor Hughes cuts it off and plays it through center. Now Sekula picks that up and dumps it right back in. Now Mark Palmer plays up to Connor Hughes. Hughes through the middle. Gets a pass to Robinson. Robinson shoots. Volpe makes the stop. 3:11 left in the third period. And that'll be an icing call on the Americans unless Rob Godfrey can get... 3:05 left in the third period. 5-2 Riders lead. .05 left in the third. Ryan McLeod in the draw with Rick Kiskis. Great Falls wins it. Zach Hedrick plays it up on the near side boards for Dwyer. Now Dwyer.
2 minutes. Served by numbers.
Dwyer puts a puck out front, but the Riders there to collapse back to the man, and they all collapse around Rick Kiskis. But now the puck in front of the net. Nali is down, and they score. That makes it a 5-3 hockey game. Americans still shorthanded, though. As the Riders may be guilty of letting up a little bit there. Now off the faceoff, the Americans chip the puck to the Fernie line. Godfrey plays it quickly to Stout. Stout off the sideboards for Hughes. Riders would be very timely if they could hand back another goal here. That goal coming at the 17:32 mark. Now Hedrick in over the line. Riders take over though. Connor Hughes stick handles behind his own net. Watched there by Kiskies. Now out to center ice for Robinson. Robinson in over the line. Dwyer catching up. Robinson with a shot. Went off of a man in front. Now back to the point for Stout. He put a shot on net. The rebound, they score! Jared Saylor! So Zach Hedrick scores for the Americans. And then Fernie comes right back to put back a three-goal lead. Zach Hedrick scoring the goal a couple minutes ago there for Great Falls. That's a sixth on the season. For the Fernie Ghost Riders, Jared Saylor, as Connor Hughes comes down with a chance, even strength. For Jared Saylor on the year, that is his 21st goal. Now Great Falls in their own zone, 1:08 left in this third period. Bobby Robbins gives Chubotti a bit of a bump as the Riders are caught offside.
Started to think that the Ghost Riders are having an awful power play. They managed to bring it down into the end and score a goal.
They've given up a couple of chances shorthand, and it did cost them tonight. But as long as, I guess, you never want to get scored on. But if you're scoring more on the power play than you're giving up shorthanded, I guess you're okay. But, yeah, the shorthanded goals are never what you want to see, obviously. But right now the Ghost Riders, 3-for-8 on the power play by my count. And they're doing such a good job answering back. Great Falls scores, they answer right back. Now the puck down the ice, Ali.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we'll play it. And now a high stick calls the play dead. Falls was allowed to get the momentum. How do you think Fernie's done as far as answering back?
It's been fabulous. You know, they've had to do it to keep themselves in the game. Ali has done well when they've been shorthanded. He's kept them in the game as well. It's just been dynamite. Dynamite game.
33 seconds left now. 6-3, Riders lead. The midget female provincial champs have just shown up at the arena. The Fernie girls taking that title. Off the faceoff, Great Falls tries to get the puck towards the front of the net. Riders keep him to the outside. Ty Dienema battles with Jeremy Robinson. Now the puck comes off the sideboards to Matt Bidlon. Bidlon gets it back to Prince. He's bumped by Mark Palmer. Now the puck down low behind the net. Ali makes a stop and he'll hang on. Now Murphy off the near sideboards and down the ice, and that should do it. Just about added to the score. There was Connor Hughes. And now the Ghost Riders will likely do their victory lap around the ice. Free Jay McCauley. Do it for the third period here as Sean gets a shot of the midget female provincial champs, the Fernie Blade Runners. Congratulations to them. Chill championship banner. You can't get a better night of hockey going than this, folks. Americans by a score of 6-3. We're back here tomorrow night. Do it all over again. Same team, same time.
Thanks, girls.
first game show on Kootenai Cable. I don't think it's going to be a 14-minute one like the one after Kimberly, but what do you say about this game? I mean, the thing that impressed me the most, I think, you can talk about the fact that Fernie did it to Great Falls again at home. They're now 4-3 against Great Falls. You can talk about the anything you want about the game, but the thing that impressed me the most was when Great Falls scored to bring the game within two goals, Fernie responded right away each time, once by Popovich, once by Saylor, and those two goals by Popovich, how good is he feeling? They were nice goals. A lot of players panic when they get in that close. Volpe went down, and Popovich put that thing under the crossbar. And what was with that first goal? Squared himself to Volpe backwards, yeah. And just back. I mean, Popovich has got to be very happy. He drew a couple penalties tonight. He played a good game, but I was just impressed. And Popovich had one of those goals, why I bring his name up, at how the Ghost Riders were able to come back and restore their three-goal lead each time Great Falls cut into it.
Yeah, you said it. And I think it was a hard work. And everybody has to remember, this team has been doing this for the last 2 months. Hard work, playing positioning, and again, we got two power play goals tonight. That is huge. Great Falls got a couple as well in a shorthanded, which was costly for us. But those two power play goals that we did get were massive. And the thing is now, the opposition knows it. The Great Falls Americans know it now. You do not take penalties against us. We're moving the puck so well now, and we're getting priceless goals. And I'm talking beauties. Goaltenders out of the positioning, going underneath the crossbar, just awesome shots. And that Coma shot was amazing.
That's probably the one I didn't see because right about that time, McLeod had been tattooed into the boards, and I was watching to see if he made it back to the bench okay, and all of a sudden I hear the crowd go wild, so I missed that one. I'm going to have to check it out on the tape here, but yeah, Jakob Coma, what can you say about him tonight? 4 points. He's now taken over third spot in the league, scoring. Anders Linden can't catch him for third. He was behind Linden for fourth, but Kimberly's not playing any more games, so... I just spoke to Coleman in the dressing room, actually, and he told me the beginning of the year he hoped for 50 points. He's got 76 now, and if he has another four-point night tomorrow night, he's got 80 points on the year. For a kid who's hoping for 50, that's not too shabby.
Yeah, put it this way. Everybody remember the team that we had last year, and we had the three top players. Trent Omer, 86 points. Charlie Matastor for 83 points. Kevin Olsen, 83 points. Coma ranks up with those type of players. He's amazing. And I said it also, I said, in order to have a contender and be the aggressor and have a chance at the Bourne Cup Championship, you had to have more than three players in the top 20. Great Falls only has three players, Kissies, Dwyer, and Moe, and they got problems. They've been losing, and they've been losing bad to some teams. They lost like 8-2 to Billings. They lost Bismarck as well, and now they lose to us on our ice, and they haven't beaten us here. They have to be motivated to try and beat us. They have to, because if we face them in the playoffs, they know it, and they see the crowd reaction and the boards and the ice, and it's so soft, and sometimes you can move around in the corners and that, but when you get tagged in the boards, you're going to get hurt. And again, it was hard work. We've been doing it for the last 2 months, and the fans are loving it. And hey, what can you say? Well, priceless that I seen tonight. The game was over. Players are skating off the ice. There was one player inside the box of the visitor team, and it was Pat Dwyer, and he had tears in his eyes. Now you got, they're probably one of their best players at 17 years old, and everybody remember, he's young. This kid makes mistakes just like anybody else, but he has tears in his eyes. He's frustrated, and he knows it, because if they come up in here, they're going to have one hell of a fight.
That's good. That is going to be their motivation. I talked to a lot of the guys on the road trip before we played our final game in Great Falls, and they wanted to win in Great Falls because they hadn't done it all year, and you don't want that goose egg on your side of the ledger when you're looking at whether you won in their building or not. But the bottom line is we're 4-3 against Great Falls now with a chance to win the season series 5-3. We play well against the top teams right now. Word is, I don't know for sure, but I heard Billings lost tonight. That's what I was told. I'm just hoping that was the right score back from our studio. But, I mean, it's going to be a battle. I mean, I called Billings about 15 games ago and said if it came down to Billings in third, they would probably come after us because they were playing so well against us at the time. But then towards the end of the season, I started to realize that they just don't have a good record against Kimberly. Neither does Bismarck.
No.
And so we go on the road to start the playoffs, so be it. By the time this airs, we'll probably be into the series already. But it's going to be a war. And games like tonight, I said it in the pregame show, I think it's important. I think it's a good break for the Ghost Riders. They get Great Falls twice at the end of the season. Yeah. This team gets up for Great Falls, and they're going to head into the playoffs on a high.
You betcha. And the first team we got to play is the Billings Bulls. You know, I was looking on the chat page there, and they figure they should be able to take us four games in four. Well, if you look at the chat lines, the fans are already a little cautious now. And a lot of them were watching and looking up on the score notes what was happening here. Again, Billings, they had success against Great Falls, but they also struggled against Great Falls too, and everybody had to remember that. But it's a blast. I can't wait. This is what we're seeing right now. The Riders have been doing it since early February. They clamp down, they start scoring on their power play, and they're playing disciplined hockey. We made a couple mistakes tonight, and it cost us a couple goals. But again, watching the Great Falls players skating to the bench and the expressions on their face, they're frustrated, and you see it. And that's the number one team in the league. Frustrations now before you get into playoffs. Great Falls has Butte. Butte's got nothing to lose. Great Falls is going to have their hands full.
Yeah, I don't know. Butte, how do you, if you're Bismarck, how do you go into Butte? I mean, granted, they had the 34-game losing streak or whatever it was at the time, but with home ice on the line, they know if they lose that game, Kimberly gets home ice because then there's only one game left. Kimberly holds a tiebreak in the season series, and that's all they can do is tie Kimberly for points now. How do you, with that motivation, walk into Butte and lose 5-3? There's problems in Bismarck right now. I think there's problems in Great Falls right now, and they're two of the top five teams. A team like Kimberly, who ended up in fourth but is not playing well towards the end of the season, there's a lot of problems in Kimberly. There's three of the top five teams. Really, Billings is average right now. Mm-hmm. I don't know much about Minot. I heard they got some injury problems. Yeah. Or no, Bismarck's the injury problems. But Minot, I mean, they're top two scorers. Haven't been scoring a lot lately. There's no team right now that's clearly on a roll heading in the playoffs except for the Bozeman Ice Dogs and the Fernie Ghost Riders. Number 6 and 7 could come out of the first round, and then we could see a number 6 and 7 in the AWHL final if things stay this way.
Well, Coach Todd Jones says it. When we lost that game 2-0 to Bozeman, the article in the Bozeman paper said they witnessed the two hardest working teams in the league. And that's serious. Like, the you go out there and you crash and bang, you look for your opportunities. But when you get teams like that and they keep coming at you on a relentless pace, man, if you already start getting frustrated and taking stupid penalties and cheap penalties and you start scoring on your power plays, you got problems. And we witnessed it tonight. And I can't wait. It's going to be fun time. If you've seen this on TV, getting ready for the playoffs, you better check it out because it's going to be awesome hockey. I like our chances. We are going to defend the Bourne Cup championship without a doubt. And we're going to make the fans proud. And I believe that really. At this pace that these guys are playing, we've been doing it for the last 2 months. We're coming back from injury players. Aquila was playing tonight. Hopefully, Kyle Shane will be back. Fourth line is going to be scary. And we got three lines scoring compared to Great Falls that only has one. Big time.
Yeah, that's something we got to talk about. I mean, we got to look forward to tomorrow night's game and not much past that right now. And I'm hoping that's what the guys are doing. It looked like they were doing okay with that tonight. I don't think they're looking ahead to Billings yet, but they got to be in the back of their minds. But we got to talk about the lines to finish off this post game. You're looking at the number one line, or it's 1A and 1B. Sometimes you can call it a second line. Sometimes you call it 1A and 1B. You got the Coma, Pechea, McLeod line. You're going to keep Robinson, Palmer, and Hughes together. I'm not sure what the third line is going to look like, but you're probably looking at possibility of Kyle Shane, Brett Downey, and Jared Saylor. Yeah. Well, that's a good third line right there. That's a heck of a good third line. Exactly. And your fourth line would end up being somebody like Wasmuth, Popadich, and like, I don't want to forget anybody, but Aquila, or Kissick, or Nansen.
Hey, those guys can fit in. Just like that, no problems. And the best thing about it, you start rotating healthy guys into your lineup, motivates even more. And another thing we got to say, too, look at the girls for the provincial championship. Those boys witnessed celebration of a championship team. That's going to motivate them.
It's I was just saying to somebody in the stands, I was saying, I hope that's us in a couple of months right there, skating around the ice with. And you know, if it does end up being the two hardest working teams in the league in the finals, we get home ice in that. So who knows? But well, that'll wrap it up for tonight in the Great Falls game. Same teams, same time tomorrow night. Right now, 4-3 advantage in the season series for Fernie. But hopefully they can play well in the last game and go into the playoffs on a roll.
Hard work, and make it pay, and beat Great Falls, and get ready for the playoffs. Again, go Riders, go. AWHL Bourne Cup Championship playoffs are about to begin, and you're going to have a lot of fun.
That'll do it for tonight. Great Falls Americans lose to the Fernie Ghost Riders 6-3. Now the Riders 4-3 against them on the season, back with the same teams tomorrow night. It's going to be a battle tomorrow night. I think Great Falls, as you said, is going to be motivated. Fernie wants to go in the playoffs on a high. Should be a dandy game tomorrow night. Do tune into that one. I'm Michael Goodwin. This is Sean Petkow. We're out.